It's Beanie here and welcome back to my channel for another speed build, and today we're back again in Evergreen Harbor to create another container home. Now, as you can see, this container home is an unusual shape and I was inspired by a neighboring residential lot where the Evergreen Harbor family lives, and when I visited that lot with my sim, I was really inspired by how they use the containers in a T-shape, and I wanted to build a T-shape home as well, but I wanted to make it a much more grand and a much more comfortable living type of home and somewhere that is stylish. So that's what I went for. And the second inspiration that I had was the yellow irrigated part, and that was inspired by a fellow YouTuber called Mermaplay. Mermaplay does Let's Plays and she does Sims 4 speed build, and well, her creativity and builds are fantastic. And on the EA gallery, she uploaded a bar that's called Cocktails Under Construction, and she used the same yellow irrigate path and fencing, and I was inspired by that to use that in my build, and so I did. I think it adds such a nice touch to this whole build. It makes it feel like the container home had been here for a while and had been used maybe for an industrial use, and now it's being used as a family home, and I think it works so well over here. I'm really happy how that turned out. And in terms of the exterior and landscaping, I didn't go too crazy because I wanted to again give that feeling that this container home may have been somewhere people stored things, or it may have been, you know, used for industrial use, and the community decided to change that into a residential lot where family could live and thrive and help the eco footprint of that world. And I really like how this whole area has turned out. So I didn't go too crazy with the exterior in terms of landscaping. I just kept it very overgrown and natural looking, and I put loads of rocks everywhere, and even in the garden area I did just use the plant boxes, and I kept it very simple. However, when you do step inside to this build is definitely doesn't look like industrial lot. It definitely looks like a home, and it looks like a very welcoming home. So as you enter the build, you got like a little lounge parlor area with some chairs and clutter to give that personality of the home and to show the type of Sims are living there. And behind that wall you do have like a little laundry room, like storage area, and then when you do go up the ladder onto the first floor, you've got like a little lounge area where people can play their guitars and just hang out, and it's like a nice space just to chill out. And maybe when you have your friends over, you can hang out over here. And obviously you do have the really large bathroom, and I really like this yellow wallpaper that came with the pack. As you go again upstairs to the main living area, I put the kitchen and living room area there, and I just really like the different colors I used at the end of each wall. So the living room area has like a red wall, and kitchen area has like a dark blue wall, and I just really like the color and the touch of it. It gives it so much more of a modern feel, and it makes it home feel more welcoming and somewhere that's actually stylish and looks like someone actually put some thought into the interior. So I like how that has turned out. I did only put one bedroom in this whole container home, so maybe it's perfect for like a couple who want their own space and they live lavishly in their container home and they're thinking about their eco footprint. So yeah, I went for only one bedroom over here, but I think the bedroom's a decent size, and I really like the red color that I used inside there. And the kitchen area is quite nice as well. I like how I just keep the kitchen bright with the cabinet, and I just think the whole kitchen area looks really great, and it looks very modern and it looks really realistic. And as you go into the living room area, I didn't put any TV there, and I think the whole area Jared is just so welcoming and inviting, and I really like how that has turned out. And now as you do go up to the third floor, I do pull like the fizz machine to make the fizz drinks and the candle making station, and I had in mind that this area would be used perhaps like a storage area or a place where your Sims can do hobbies and arts and crafts. So I really like how that turned out, and they do have their own little outdoor decking where I've kept the sun lounges out there, and I think it's like a really nice touch, especially now you've got a sun lounge that's high up into the sky and you can have a look at all of Port Promise. I think it's such a fantastic idea, because especially because you're near the sea, you get to see the beautiful scenery. I really like yellow irrigated pathway at the front. And guys, if you've not checked out Murmur Plays channel, do check her out, because I will leave a link to her YouTube channel in the description bar below. And in terms of this build, I will leave download link for this build in the description bar below as well, so don't forget to check that out as well. And if you like this build, give this build a thumbs up, comment about what you like about this build, and subscribe to me. So until next time, take care.